Okay,
timestamps.
Okay, bad hair day and really bad hat. I'm so sorry.
It's getting to the point where people, viewers who I am super grateful for, are asking me render-related questions. But in order for me to understand what people are asking, it would be cool if we were all on the same page as to what rendering is, what encoding is, and what exporting is, etc., etc. So that when questions are asked, I can understand what the questions actually are. And on that note, I genuinely appreciate the questions in the comments because I actually learn a lot while understanding what people's problems are and how to figure them out. So keep the questions, the requests coming. I sincerely appreciate them. That was a tangent. In this video, we will cover rendering, rendering previews, encoding, and exporting. And all the forums and materials that help with my research on this topic are linked below. Okay, rendering previews. A preview is exactly that. By default, it's a low-res version of your edited clip that Premiere Pro can refer to instead of trying to read the source clip and its layers of edits, which often play back jumpy because they're too intensive to play smoothly in real time. That's a preview, and I render previews in short segments relatively often in my editing workflow. So for example, you import your clip. For most of us, this will be a compressed clip, let's say a 4K clip, and this already gives us a yellow render bar notification here because it's a 4K 10-bit 422 clip. Yellow means that we'll probably be able to play this back in real time. Probably. Now, for a full explanation of the red and yellow render bars and how to make them green, I have a video on that topic linked above and down below if that's something you might be interested in. Okay, we add some lumetry adjustments, etc., and we get a red render bar. Now, if this line were green, it would be an indication that this clip has a rendered preview associated with it. As you can see by the red or the yellow, the segment doesn't have a preview associated with it. Now, my system is set to save previews as low-res 720p preview files when working in a 16:9 sequence. It makes the rendering of previews a little faster, which is best for me, as I predominantly don't use my previews for final export unless I'm desperate for a fast export and willing to trade quality for time. Time for quality. Okay, with these tweaks, my footage doesn't play back smoothly in real time anymore. I could set my playback to run at an eighth of the quality, but I don't want to do that right now, as I want to watch this properly before exporting it. So I want Premiere Pro to render previews of this compressed source data by decoding whatever codec it is and processing the edits to give us a rendered preview in whatever codec our previews are set to. So if I'm not mistaken, the default is a 720p MPEG codec if you're working in a 16:9 sequence. And you can check those details out by navigating to Sequence and Sequence Settings. To render previews, you can enable the work area bar like this by hitting Alt open square brackets, option for Mac, then set the end brackets and Alt close square brackets. Okay, so this is my render area. Navigate to Sequence and render entire work area. And we now have our green bar, meaning that we have saved previews stored in my Scratch drive. You can tell Premiere Pro which directory to designate as your Scratch, and it's recommended that you keep your Scratch directory in a separate SSD to your project. You can set this when opening a new project or by navigating to File, Project Settings, and Scratch Disks. A full breakdown of my hardware workflow is in the mix and will be linked above and down below once it's up on the channel. Okay, so we have our low quality preview so we can watch our edits in our panel in real time, and I tend to render out my entire project like this before exporting so I can debug any render issues I may encounter during my final export before I actually export. I made a full video on this, which I'll link above and down below if that's something you might be interested in. Okay, that's rendering a preview for smooth project playback. In addition to using your previews for this, you can use the previews during your final export, which I wouldn't recommend for a final project export because our previews, at least mine, are set to 720p previews. But if you choose to do this, you can select that option here in this box using Use Previews in the Final Export panel. You can set your previews to be rendered and stored in full quality that matches your source data so that you can use max quality previews for your exports, and this is called smart rendering. But this doesn't fit as part of my workflow because I strictly render previews to allow for smooth playback while editing and to debug my project before final export, and that's it. Now let's reverse it little and go through what exporting or outputting is. The export process includes the rendering, similar to what we've just discussed with decoding the source data and processing the edits, and then also encoding, which is essentially a codec translation. So you translate the preview codec to the final exported codec, and once we understand those concepts, we'll understand where the use previews option would fit in with all of that, so you can decide when, if, how, whatever you want to use previews during your export. Now the export process firstly includes rendering, and as you did with rendering previews, we're decoding the compressed source data applying the edits and rendering the new data, but now unlike our low quality previews, we're rendering high quality outputs, if that's what we selected in the export panel. And once we have our rendered video, Premiere Pro encodes that video to whatever codec we selected for our final export. The exporting or the outputting process uses both GPU and CPU in a complementary manner, and though the GPU can be helpful for slightly speeding up the rendering of lumetri edits or warp stabilizing, my general understanding is that the export process is predominantly a CPU task, and the encoding process is primarily a CPU process. I know the latest versions of Premiere Pro have made the GPU integration more significant, but I was not having a good time with that version, so I uninstalled it and reverted. But once I understand this GPU-CPU topic better, I'll definitely make a video on that. Now, if we want our exports to run a little faster, if we've already rendered previews, we can tell Premiere Pro to use those previews and transcode those to our final codec of choice. But if you're transcoding low-res previews to a 4K codec, for example, your final export, as one might expect, will not be a max quality export. Now, this would be handy if you're going to be exporting rough cuts various times with some added tweaks here and there. There are lots of scenarios where this would be a feasible option. A couple of times I've made some heavy edits where I just couldn't be bothered to wait 23 hours for an export, so I just use previews. Now, if you choose to set your previews to render in a full quality, you can entirely skip the rendering step during your export using smart rendering. This involves checking match sequence settings and use previews, but be sure to set your previews to max quality. And I'll link a video that covers smart rendering and all this stuff in a bit more detail. I don't use smart rendering, so I won't elaborate on that further, as it does hold some caveats. Okay, we've covered a little bit of everything I wanted to go through in this video. So in discussing Premiere Pro topics or questions, it would be great if we were all on the same page. Rendering most generally refers to rendering of previews, and when it comes to exporting, we generally refer to encoding or exporting. And when discussing After Effects projects, the exported file is often referred to as a render, and that's probably an animation VFX thing. I'll link any in-depth explanation that I found useful down below, and let's end things there. If you're into the music I've been using in my videos of late, feel free to check out and explore audio.com's music licensing catalog. They are running a holiday deal where you can pay one price to get lifetime access to their royalty-free music licensing, thousands of high-quality tracks at hands down the best value. I've made various videos covering my thoughts and opinions, so feel free to explore those. If you're a new-time filmmaker, YouTuber, vlogger, commercial content creator, looking for some of the best music to incorporate in your videos, I do recommend you give them a listen. Details linked below. And that's it for today, folks. If you found this video helpful, useful, entertaining, if you feel you may have learned something, feel free to give it a thumbs up if that's something you do. Share, subscribe if that's something you might be interested in doing. All that good stuff. As always, thank you so much for watching. I sincerely appreciate you being here, and I'll catch you in the next video.